Magandang araw po sa lahat ng nanonood ngayon sa kanilang mga home churches at magandang or pinagpalang araw sa inyong lahat. Amin po. Ngayon po tayo ay nandirito sa tahanan nila Sister Nesle Gregorio. Ito po ay under ng Pen 1, under Pastor Ferdinand Lopez. Sister Nesle, sino po ang leader ninyo dito sa home church na ito?
Ako po, Pastor.
Okay, si Sister Nesle po ang leader. At pwede niyo po bang ipakilala sa atin dito kung sino yung mga kasama ninyo?
Opo, si mag-umpisa po kasi hipag ko po si Sis Shirley Habon. Sa kapitbahay ko po na Sis Lelia Antiesa and si sister ko po si Sis Jet Joan Omot at yung apo po ni Sis Elena Magbanwa, si Ishi Nicole po Magbanwa. At yung anak ko po si Princess Nekamay. At yung sister ko po si Grace, Sis Grace Dagas.
Ayan. Palakpakan natin bawat isa. Okay, Sister Nesle, may isang katanungan na lang ako na itatanong sa inyo. Ano po ang naitulong ng bagong form ng home church natin sa home church ninyo ngayon?
Dati po kasi hindi po kami nagkakaisa ng home church. Kanya-kanya po. Tapos hindi po namin nasusubaybayan kung nasaan po yung ibang member, kung nag-a-attend, kung active pa po sila, kung nakakapag-worship. Sa parang ito, nagkakaisa kami sa pakikinig. At sa ganun, na-i-share namin yung mga karanasan namin at yung mga blessing ni God sa amin.
Amen. Palakpakan natin. Po, tayo po ay humanda na sa ating pong pagsamba sa Panginoon. Nandito tayo upang sambahin at purihin ang ating Diyos sa pamamagitan ng home church. So, let us prepare our hearts para sa ating pag-worship sa Panginoon. At gusto ko rin pong ipakilala sa inyo ang ating mga kasama sa music team, ang ating lead singer, walang iba, si Ate Aubrey Mandagan, at ang ating guitarist, syempre, ang ever faithful, si Kuya Michael Grapani, at ang ating pong mga videographer, ay walang iba, ang ating kapatid na magpapastor, walang iba si Kuya Peter Jan Cabalse.
Handa na po ba tayong magpuri sa ating Panginoon?
Amen!
Let's sing kay Buti ng Diyos!
Kay Buti ng Diyos, kay Buti ng Diyos sa amin. Kay Buti ng Diyos, kay buti ng Diyos sa iyo. Kay buti ng Diyos, kay buti ng Diyos sa kanya. Kay buti ng Diyos, kay buti ng Diyos sa lahat. Ibalak ka ang kumay at ating ikaw ay sabayan mo ng at sumayaw sa iyo, ipahayag mo kapatid na kay buti ng Diyos, kay buti ng Diyos sa atin.
Minsan
kay buti ng Diyos, kay buti ng Diyos sa atin. Kay buti ng Diyos sa iyo, kay buti ng Diyos, kay buti ng Diyos sa kanya. Kay buti ng Diyos, kay buti ng Diyos sa lahat. Yeah. Pagumuhan ko araw-araw. Ngayon, bukas at kailanman ang pag-ibig niya ay laging sapat.
Natatangin kayamanan ko, ikaw ay sambahin.
ko po, Sister Nestle, para sa ating pong opening prayer.
Manalangin po tayo. Maraming salamat po, Panginoon, sa pagkakataong ito. Salamat din po sa mga kapatid ko na pumarito para maganap ang pagpupuri para sa iyo, Panginoon. Salamat din po, Panginoon, kay Pastor Lee na lagi mo pong ginagamit upang ibahagi ang banal mong salita. Sampu ng kanyang mga kasamahan na tunay na dalisay ang mithiing iaalay para sa iyo, Panginoon. Panginoon, alam po namin na muli kaming pagpapalain sa araw na ito. At nandyan ka para samahan kami simula ang isa hanggang dulo. Panginoon, alam na patawarin po kami sa aming mga pagkakasala na minsan po kami ay naglabis, minsan naman po ay nagkulang. Minsan din naman po ay nawala kami sa focus. Pero para sa iyo, Panginoon, handa po kami gamitin ang authority mo para itaboy ang kaanggawa ng mga kalaban. Panginoon, bilang ganti sa iyong mga kabutihan, buong puso po namin iaalay ang aming buhay para sa iyo, Panginoon. Gabayan mo po kami sa buong oras na to at sa susunod pa po, sa walang hanggang pagmamahal mo po hanggang sa susunod na buhay. Ito po ang aming dalangin at pasasalamat sa iyo. Sa ngalan ni Jesus. Amen.
Ngayon naman po, ihanda na po natin ang ating mga sarili para sa pakikinig ng salita ng Diyos. This is the right time to receive the grace of God through the Word of God. Amen?
Amen.
So, handa na po ba tayo na makinig ng salita ng Diyos?
Amen. Amen.
So, ipapakilala ko po ang ating mga speaker for today. Sa English, ang ating pong, walang iba po, kundi ang ating Senior Pastor Reverend David Lee. At sa Tagalog naman po, ay walang iba, kundi ang inyong lingkod, Pastor Ramir na Intrata. Palagpalag po natin ang Panginoon.
Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. Let us greet with our side person. Let us receive the blessing of the desert. Let us receive the blessing of the desert. So today the topic is blessing of the desert. Joshua chapter 1 verses 1 to 9. I really want all of our church members to receive the blessing of the desert. What is the desert? Desert means from the word of God. Original word of the desert in Hebrew, Midbaru. What is the Midbaru? Midbaru meaning to say from the word of God. This the desert, there was nothing. There was no food, there was no house, there was no something, the water. That's why it's very hard. It's very difficult to live there. That's why without God, people can't live. It is the desert. Even though God already knew there was nothing, but why our God led the Israelites to desert? Meaning to say there was the something plan of God. So while Israelites live in the Egypt for 430 years, they have the long imprinted and then looted and nature as the slave. Their life was their very misery as the slave. So that our God want to heal these kinds of the something, the imprinted and then looted and natured in their life. So when we see the people, there was a lot of the division in their life. What is the division? You know, our the mental is the divided each one another. There was the something events in Korea. Last time I already tell you, 1 in 6 months, the baby was the patay because of the adopted parents. They spanked her. That's why this the small baby passed away. Even though Shai sister the 18 months only, but this the parents adopted after that, continually they spank, and finally this the baby was passed away. And there was the another story. There was the tatlong daughters and then one mother. They live together. These are the three daughters. They have one business. That's why every day their mother came and cleans this the business area. But one day This the tatlong daughters killed her mother with the stick, spank, kick, and finally they killed their mother. Do you understand why this one is happening in the words? You know, in the ethics, we cannot understand. This the mother was the one to deliver us in this the words and raise us until we are here. But why they killed this the children? I mean, why this the children, daughters, they killed their mother? Because of the capture by Satan. All their the thinking and mind captured by Satan. That's why there is the mental division. When mentally there was the division in their life, and they cannot be right. They cannot thinking about the rights. You know, most of the people we have something distinguished. You and me, we are the different. No, all of us, we are the same. There are many kinds of the mental division issues that are coming up. When we encounter financial problem, why we have the mental division? Why we are the worry? Why we are the anger? Why we are afraid? Why we encounter the family problem? Why we are the worry? Why we are the upset? You know, that is why our the mental issues are the divided. When we encounter something, the trouble problem, why we have the mental division in our the life? Because this the Satan capture our the mental. Satan capture our the minds and hearts. That's why we have the something destroy our the mental. That's why there is the division of our the mental. You know, after this the division of the mental, there is the obsession and addiction to drink the liquor and the drug addiction and game addiction, and they parents the gambling addiction, sex addiction, they parents the obsession and addiction. Then many people say, oh, why they are parents the drug addiction and game addiction, something like this. No, all of us, it is the same. They are, and then we are the same. All this, the obsession and division came from what? Came from fundamental problem, spiritual problem. If you don't thinking about this, the drug addiction and sex addiction and the recall addiction, this is the spiritual problem. If you don't thinking about that, we cannot help them. All, everyone, it is the same. Even pastor, even someone parents the drug, it is the equal, same. We are parents to the work addiction. Someone parents to the gambling addiction. Someone parents to the game addiction. Someone parents to the drug addiction. All the same. Same addiction. Same obsession. That's why all this one, it is the came from Satan. It is the spiritual problem. Satan captured our heart and minds. There is no happiness. That's why Satan made us to addict, to obsess to the game, gambling, and something, you know, liquor, and then like this, the drug. That's why all this, the obsession and addiction, it is the came from spiritual problem. And then after that, when we have the like this, the obsession and addiction, we have the what? We have the disease in our the body. You know, because of the addiction, because of the obsession, you could not sleep, you could not eat much. Then what happened? Time passed by, then our the body getting weak, and we have something disease in our the body. That's why our the life will be destroyed. Our the member, all people nowadays, because of the COVID-19, there is the criminal is the increase a lot, especially in Japan, in America. There is a lot of the something mental disease. They kill the mother and father. You know, in America, very severe. They spank the children. You know, that's why they have the accuse. You know, a lot of the mental problem is coming up. Many people say because of the COVID-19. No, it's not COVID-19. You know, this the COVID-19 is the one of the reason, but already this the kinds of the mental problem came to our the life. Why? Satan intervened to our the life. So, since we are born, we are separated from God. That's why, you know, we become sinner. When we become sinner, according to the Bible, 1 John chapter 3, verse 8, we are belongs to Satan. That's why Satan, since we are born, Satan captured our the mind and our heart. Satan captured our the life and physical body. That's why Satan continually make us to have the obsession and addiction. Satan continually captured our the mind and heart. That's why we have the mental division in our the life, our the members. How can we heal? Without Jesus, we cannot be healed. That's why our God brought the Israelite to heal this the kinds of the problem in the desert. Number one, you know, we can find out the limitation of the member, limitation of the believer. Even though we believe in Jesus Christ, why we have the limitation? Why we have the problems in our the life? Because this the limitation, it is the instruments to experience the power of God. Through this the imitation, members can experience the power of God. If there's wala nang limitation, you will not look for Jesus Christ. You don't need the Jesus Christ. Why? You are the superman, superwoman. That's why you can do all things. No need God anymore. So that this the three organization all the times made the people say that, you know, you are God. You don't need God anymore. You know, that's why this the city organization make the people to pair into the self-centeredness. But you know what happened? Why you have this the limitation in our the life? Even though we believe in God, if we believe in Jesus Christ, why we have the limitation? Because, you know, we are our the centeredness is the what? Physical centeredness. We have the Genesis chapter 3, 6 and 11. Our the measurement is the what? Physical measurement. All the times we just measure by ourselves. That's why we have the limitation. I can't. Why I can't? Because that is the measurement of myself. Physical measurement. All the times we see the physical measurement. If there is someone who doing very well, then we have the parents the temptation. Yeah, siya is the very magaling. But ako, hindi magaling. That's why I can't. I can't. Why I can't? God is the living. God is with us. Nothing is impossible in God. You know, our the members, really, we must recover our the gospel. When we pair into the Genesis chapter 3, self-centeredness. Genesis chapter 6, money-centeredness. Genesis chapter 11, successful-centeredness. All the times our the measurement is the what? Ourself. So that when we see through this one, oh, walang pera, that's why I'm just downcast. I'm not success. I'm not good in study. I don't have any authority. That's why we are downcast. Why? This is the physical measurement. If you are the success, if you have something authority, you have a lot of the money, you study well, then yourself is something is going up. Why? Physical measurement. All the times people living with the physical measurement. So you see the Moses. Moses grew up in the Egypt. While he was the grow up in the Egypt in palace, he was the very strong power. And then Meron Shang study well. And then also Meron Shang the very wise, study a lot. So that he tried to save the Israelites by his own power. So that when this the Moses tried to save the Israelites through his own power, limitation is the coming. One day, this the Moses found out this the Hebrews, one Hebrews the suffered by the Egyptian. That's why this the Moses spanked the Egyptian. One time, this the Egyptian patay. That's why when he saw this the Israelites, Jewish is the coming to the Moses. Also, you will spank us like what you killed Egyptian soldier. That's why suddenly this the Moses encounter a lot of the outrage. And then something pure is the coming up in his heart. So he run away. So he thought, maybe King Pharaoh will kill me. Kasi I killed this the one Egyptian soldiers. That's why this the Moses run away. It was the 40 years old. So when Moses ran away, he stayed in the Midian desert. When he stayed in the desert of the Midian, he met his wife and he lived with the Jethro. And while living in the desert, he thinking about a lot. All his something he found out his the limitation. My limitation is like this, like this, like this, like this. Why? Self-centeredness? money centeredness, and success percentness. I'm nothing. That's why Moses recognized my problem is not the money, my problem is not the success, but my problem is the what? My problem is the spiritual problem. Problem is not the problem, problem is the what? Spiritual problem, intervened by Satan. That's why I have the absolute impossible life. Whatever I do, I can do nothing. Why? Because Satan holding my life. So that Moses recognized his the problem is the spiritual problem. That's why he recognized that he needs the Jesus Christ. He holds the gospel. And he writes the book of the Genesis. Genesis chapter 3 verse 15. You know why this the offspring of woman must come to the world? Because all people, they are captured by Satan since we are born. Our heart and mind captured by Satan. Our life and physical body captured by Satan. Without Jesus, without God, we can't be saved. That's why Moses wrote the book of the Genesis. And then when he wrote the book of the Genesis, he really realized Genesis chapter 3 verse 15. So that this the Moses, when opened his the spiritual eyes, when he opened the spiritual eyes, he confessed to the King Pharaoh in Exodus chapter 3 verse 18. Please let us, allow us to go to the mountain to worship God, blood sacrificial. You know, this the blood sacrificial, it is the symbol of the Jesus Christ. Why we are captured by Satan? Because of the kasalanan. So that in order to solve all our the sin, our Jesus Christ must die under the cross. That's why this the Moses said to the King Pharaoh, please let us to go to the desert, mountain, to worship to our God. You know, it's meaning to say Moses overcome this the limitation. Our the church member, we have the maraming limitation. Some man, you have walang job. Some man, you don't have any foods. Some man, you don't study. Some man, your business is not going well. Some man, you have the separate, you are the husband and wife. Children problem and family problem. We have a lot of the limitation. Members, let us thinking about why this the limitation is the coming up. Why all the times you confess that I can't. Why you can't? Because of the physical measurement. Please is the off your the physical measurement. Our God wants you to restore not physical measurement, but God's centeredness in your life. You know, there is the 12 spies in Numbers chapter 14. These the 12 spies was sent to explore whole lands of the land of the Canaan for 40 days. After the 40 days, these the 12 spies came back to the Moses. They report. You know, these the sampung spices. They report to the Moses and holy Israelites. Yeah, this the land of the Canaan, it was so beautiful. And this the fruits was the very big and very magandang lands. But problem is, there was the giants. All these the people in the land of the Canaan, they were almore. So that they are parang giants, we are parang locusts. That's why we cannot conquer. Let's go back to the Egypt. You know why this the spies, why they have the negative reports, why they have the physical reports? That is the true, that is the tama. They didn't lie. That is the actual fact. But problem is the what? Why they said in the last we cannot conquer? Because they are parang giants, we are the locusts. Let's go back to the Egypt. Why they have the conclusion? Because of the physical measurement. Because of the limitation. All the time they watch over wherever they go, 40 days while they explore whole land of the Canaan. All the times there's the eyes is the what? Physical eyes. They watch over everything through the physical eyes. Now you are poor? Yeah, why you see your the surroundings with your the physical eyes? You know, this the dalawang spies, Joshua and Caleb, was the very different. Even though it was the same actual part, they said, yeah, it is the very true what they report about the land of the Canaan. You know, we also explore this the whole land of the Canaan for 40 days. After the 40 days, we explored, what is the conclusion, result? Let's go up to conquer this, the land of the Canaan. Because God is with us. Even though they are strong, even though they are giants, but God is with us. That's why they are our lies. You know, this the Sampong spies and then Dalawang spies was the very different the conclusion. Why? This the Sampong spies, they have the limitation. But this the Dalawang spies, wala nang limitation. Why? This the Sampong spies, all the time, they see everything through the Genesis chapter 3, 6, and 11. Physical measurement. But this the Dalawang spies, Joshua and Caleb, this the measurement was not physical measurement, spiritual measurement. God was the measurement. If God is with us, nothing is impossible in God. I will remember, are you difficult now? What is the difficult? Financially difficult? Why our God is the living? Even though our God is the living, why our God allow you this the difficulties? Why our God allow us this the COVID-19 in the world? Why God allow us this the situation in our life? This is the plan of God. Our God had the plan of God. We must overcome our limitation. How can we overcome our limitation? All the times you must listen to the gospel. While you are listening to the gospel, your limitation will be overcome. You know, in the desert, all the times they were living with the tabernacle. While they are living with the tabernacle, when they were the stay, the you know, all this the Tatalong tribes, every area they were located it, the east, west, north, and south. All the time they are the Tatalong tribes, they were positioned. That's why all the times they were together to the tabernacle. This the tabernacle is the symbol of the Jesus Christ. According to the Rome chapter 10, verse 17, faith comes from the listening to the word of God, which is the message of the Christ. I will remember, are you difficult? You have the limitation? Brethren, still our eyes is the physical measurement. Because we have the Genesis chapter 3, 6 and 11, we have to change. We have to know that. Who give the Genesis chapter 3? Who give the Genesis chapter 6 and 11? Satan. Satan giving this the physical measurement. Satan giving this the Genesis chapter 3, 6 and 11. That's why we have the limitation. If you don't have any the Genesis chapter 3, 6 and 11, which given by Satan, if you believe that God is with you, if you really understand this the gospel, walang limitation, like Moses, like the Dalawang spies. I really want all of our the church members to overcome this the limitation. What situation you are, what problem you encounter, it's no matter. Why? Almighty God, Creator God is with you always. Number two, healing. You know, our God wants to heal through this the desert. That's why desert will be the blessing for us. What kinds of the things our God will heal? Number one is the unbelief. We have a lot of the unbelief in our life. You know, why we have the unbelief? Because of the Satan. All the time Satan giving the Genesis chapter 3, 6 and 11. When Satan giving the Genesis chapter 3, 6 and 11, unbelief is the coming. Who am I? Satan make us. You see yourself. When I see myself, when I compare with the others, I have the pain to the unbelief. I can't. That's why in the church, pastor said to the some member, please doing this, the teacher's ministry, doing this, the ministry. Oh, pastor, I can. Why you said I can't? Because of the physical measurement. Meaning to say you have the unbelief. You don't believe in God. Nothing is impossible in God. You know, originally God creates the human to live with God. That's why being living with God, it is the fundamental being of the human. So that when we are living with God, there is the unlimited. Walang hanggang. So that wala nang limitation, wala nang unbelief. If God is with you, when we accept the Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit came to our hearts. Holy Spirit dwells in me, in our hearts. Then it's meaning to say, wala nang unbelief. Don't look your environments. These are the disciples. they were together with the Jesus. One day, they were sailing in the Sea of the Galilee. Why they were sailing in the Sea of the Galilee? There was the great storm, and Jesus Christ got sleeping. You know, these are the disciples, they tried to save the boat and Jesus Christ because they were boatmen. That's why they tried to their best. But it was the very severe, they can't do nothing. That's why they said to the Jesus, Jesus, don't you care of us? We are going to die. They are so afraid and they lose their hope to alive. That's why Jesus Christ, after the wake up, said to the Jesus, disciples, you little of faith, until how long I have to be with you? Jesus Christ called the disciples. Why Jesus called the disciples? Meaning to say, these are the disciples, even though they were with Jesus Christ, they don't believe. They don't believe the with the Jesus Christ. Why Jesus Christ came to this world? To die in the Sea of the Galilee? No. On the cross, in the Calvary, because of our sin, Jesus Christ must die to forgive all our sin. In order to save us from the Satan, Jesus Christ must die under the cross in Calvary, not in the Sea of the Galilee. It's meaning to say, what situation we are now, do not worry. Our God is with you. If God is with you, you will not die, you will be saved. Situation, environment, almost going to destroy. That's why these are the disciples they will worry about. But our the members do not worry about. Our God is the living God. Our God is the Almighty God. So, our the members, our God want to heal our brains, our the minds. Because our the mind lived in the Egypt for 430 years. That's why 430 years they were slaves. There's the mind already long imprinted in their brain. That's why in order to heal this the long imprinted in their minds, our God gave the something, the miracle and power in them. So that this the Israelites, they experienced the sampong miracles in the Egypt. Then finally last the miracle was the Passover. That's why when they experienced the sampong miracles in the desert, they realized that our God is the living and almighty. After that, they experienced Exodus from the Egypt. And then after that, they saw this miracle of the Red Sea. You know, in the back, there was the Egyptian soldiers. In the left and the right, they can't go. But in the front, there was the Red Sea. They cannot go forward and then back in everywhere. But you know what happened when Moses prayed to the Lord? Suddenly, this the Red Sea was divided in two. So that they across this the Red Sea like dry lands. You know, when they experience the miracles and power, they have the imprinted, new imprinted. God is Almighty. Even though we are living in the desert for 430 years, our God gave the new frame, new imprints. But problem is, even though they see this, the kinds of the miracles and power, still they didn't believe in God. All the times they complain. You know, when this the Israelites, while they were stay in the desert, our God won't heal their the heart, because their the heart was the slave for 430 years in the Egypt. All the times they using the humanism way, because of it was the something wound, slavery, it was the wound their hearts, so that our God want to heal their heart. What experience in your life? You have the emotional wounds, you have the hated by the someone, you have the something, you know, emotional wounds in your the past life, do not worry about. Our God want to heal you in the desert. Desert is not actual desert, spiritual desert. Something difficulties, something problems, something financial problems, something the jobless, and then family problem, loneliness, and every something sicknesses on your the body, accident, it is the spiritual death. In this the spiritual death, what God want to you? Number one, God want to heal your brain, your minds. Number two, God want to heal your heart. You know, this the Israelite, there was a lot of the emotional wounds in the Egypt. That's why our God want to heal this heart of the Israelite. That's why our God said to the Israelite, all the time you live with the tabernacles. This in order to heal our heart, then we need the Jesus Christ. Not only the one time, but every moment, every time, every day, we must see this the Jesus Christ. This the tabernacle is the symbol of the Jesus Christ. So that all the times there was pillar of the crowds and pillar of the fire in the evening. So that all the time they watch over, God is with us. God is with us. So that our God will heal you. So if you recognize your problem is the spiritual problem, there is no emotional wounds anymore. Before, possibly also parents with a lot of the emotional wounds. But now, I'm not parents with the emotional wounds anymore. Why? Someone says some things, I believe that, Shai sister captured by Satan. This is not him, this is not her, but Shai sister speaking, Satan. Satan is sister intervene to her, intervene to him. And that's why Shai sister treat like this. That's why I'm not parent to the temptation and emotional wounds. In order to heal there's the emotional wounds, our God make the Israelites to experience the tabernacle always. Always they need to see this the tabernacle while they are living with the tabernacle, with the Christ. Always our God heal there's the emotional wounds. Also, life healing. You know, we have a lot of the natures in our life. Every day, it was the nature. Automatically, this one is the coming. You know, when someone is the speak bad word, it automatically you are the feedback. Why? It is the nature in your life. Our God wants to heal your life. Whenever you have the difficulties, you have the cigarette, you drink the liquor, you know, you pay into the drug. You pay into the game and gamblings. Why? Because it is the something natural in your life. Long imprinted, it is the nature in your life. That's why our God wants to heal you. Through what? Through the something, Jordan River. Jordan River and the city of the Jericho. You know, when they cross the Jordan River and they need the pananampalataya. You know, this the legacy without pananampalataya already divided, and then they can across the legacy. But this the Jordan River, our God asked them pananampalataya, so that without this the pananampalataya, they cannot across the Jordan River. So they must show up there's the pananampalataya. So when they show up there's the pananampalataya, they across the Jordan River. So when they cross the Jordan River and they experience, they have something healing of the life. They have a lot of the problem in their life. But our God healed their life through Jordan River. Jordan River, it's meaning to say, patay. We must patay with the Jesus Christ. I no longer live, but Jesus Christ lives in me. So that when you truly believe in Jesus Christ, we are not no longer live, but Jesus Christ lives in me. So our the member, what problem you encounter, what difficulties you are, don't looking about your the problems and difficulties. Because our God is the living and almighty God. So that we are died already. If there's the patay, how can we move? This is the dead person, even though someone is something, you know, touching you, but there is no move anymore. Why? Patay. That is the patay. So we are patay in God. So there is no moving anymore. Our the members, our God want to heal you. You are the life. Through the what? This is the Jordan River. When we have the baptismal ceremony, we are the lay down to the immerse into the water, and then comes out. It's meaning to say we are dying with the Jesus Christ, we are living with the Jesus Christ. So in the city of the Jericho, together with the Almor person, Levite, you know, when they together with the Levite and Almor person, without any shouting, they just follow together. When they were marching once in a day, and last day seven times in one day. And then after that, when God say shouting, suddenly when they shout, follow the word of God, you know, suddenly this, the city of the Jericho was destroyed. Through this, the miracle, our God will heal our life. Even though you do nothing, our God will do. Why? Our God is Almighty God. I really want all of our the church members to be healed, all your the unbelief. And through if you have the healing of the unbelief, our God will allow meeting. Through the meeting, you can save the people. So before the healing, all the times we condemn, you know, we fell into the temptation, we have the emotional wounds, but after the healing, you know what happened? Wala nang fell into the temptation, wala nang measure, we understand each one another. Why? Every problem, it is that comes from intervened by Satan. That is the spiritual problem. Satan intervened to Shia. Satan intervened to me. That's why this the kinds of the emotion is the coming up. That's why this anger, worry, anxiety is the coming up. We understand. That's why after the healing, we will not measure. We will see all the people in the world. They have the spiritual problem. Satan intervened to their life. That's why their life was broken now. So that, what we have to do? We must tell them only Jesus is the solution of the problem of your life. When we giving this the solution, people will understand, and then people will solve all the problems and difficulties. Our members. At the time, our God allow us to meet absolute disciples. Absolute disciples, meaning to say, while we are together in the desert, then with the witness, with the Moses, with the Joshua and Caleb, they were together, and then they listened to the salita ng Dios. You know, all the times, in any situation, it's no matter. We must be there to continue. Why? Continue to attend, continue to listen to the word of God. Because our problem is the spiritual problem, and solution is only Jesus Christ. That's why, if you are absolute disciples, you will not look your environment. All the times you will see only Jesus Christ. You see, this is the Moses. Moses was together with the Joshua and Caleb. When Moses together with the Joshua and Caleb, and then this is the Moses giving the message about the Christ. And then this is the Joshua and Caleb, while they were together in the desert, continually they listened to the message of God. That's why they become absolute disciples. And what about this is the Joshua? When Joshua became a leader of the Israelites, he chose the dalawang person. This is the dalawang person was the disciple of the Joshua, and all the time he was together and delivered the message. So that this the dalawang person, wherever they go, all the times they were together with the Joshua, and they listened to the word of God. So that when Joshua sent this the dalawang person as the spies to explore city of the Jericho, they explore city of the Jericho successfully with the pananampalataya. Not physical measurement, spiritual measurement, with the spiritual eyes. And then finally, this the Salmon, one of the disciple of the Joshua, see the city of the Jericho. When he went to the city of the Jericho, he saw this the prostitute Rahab. Even though her job was the prostitute, but this the Salmon eyes was not physical measurement. It's no matter what trouble you are, what situation you are, important is the meron gospel or walang gospel. Meron pananampalataya, walang pananampalataya. Even though you have the maraming pera, even though you are a very great person, but walang pananampalataya, it's useless and meaningless. That's why this the Salmon married with the Rahab. Why? Because he saw this the Rahab meron the pananampalataya. This the Rahab confessed the pananampalataya. That's why this the Salmon married with the Rahab. Our the members, let us recognize our the spiritual problem. So when you recognize the spiritual problem, you will hold only the Jesus Christ. After that, you can deliver this the gospel to all of the world. I really want all of you to deliver this the gospel to all the nations. Let us bow down our head and then pray to our God. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for giving us this the wonderful evening, wonderful morning. And today, we listen to this the word of God. Heavenly Father, please, sister, make us to deliver this the gospel and make us to be healed by this the gospel so that all our the life will be healed by the gospel. We will deliver this the gospel to all of the world. We give you back all the praises, all the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Ngayon naman po, tayo po ay dadako sa ating mga announcement o sa ating mga paalala. So far, wala tayong masyadong mga paalala sa oras na ito, but we would like to remind you again sa ating pong ginagawang Bible study every Wednesday. Ito po ay open Bible study ng ating senior pastor, Reverend David Lee, sa lahat po ng mga member. Dito po sa Bible study na ito ay walang qualification. Anyone can join. So kung sino po yung talagang eager at na makinig ng gospel, ng salita ng Diyos, kayo po ay inaanyayahan namin na makinig every Wednesday or mag-join every Wednesday. Magsa-start po yung open Bible study na ito alas 9 po ng umaga hanggang alas 10 lang po ng umaga. So, napaka-iksing oras lang, 1 hour lang. So, kung hindi pa po kayo nakaka-join, mag-join po kayo. Makikita po ninyo yung link sa TGSMC All Members. Kung kayo po ay wala sa TGMC All Members, magpa-add po kayo sa ating mga kapatiran. Okay po? So, Wednesday po yan, 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. At patuloy din po namin ini-inform o nare-remind sa inyo na yung ating Sunday worship ay tuloy-tuloy na po yung time schedule na yan. 8:30 hanggang 10 yung first session, 10 hanggang 11:30 yung second session, at yung third session naman ay 11:30 hanggang 1 a.m. So, according to our senior pastor, from Monday hanggang Friday po, dapat makapaglista na po tayo. Especially, this na experience namin ngayong week na to, na maraming nag-aagawan sa 8:30 session. So, agahan po ninyo magpalista para hindi po kayo mahuli. And kung puno na po ang 8:30, huwag nyo pong isiksik doon yung sarili ninyo. May dalawang session pa po. May 10 to 11:30 and 11:30 to 1, yung first and second session. Ano rin po yun para protektahan tayo? Protektahan yung sarili natin at protektahan yung iba. Kaya po, hanggang 100 person lang. Doon sa sanctuary at yung balcony, yun po yung ginagamit. So, yun po, Monday hanggang Friday, kailangan po na makapagpalista na po tayo. And also reminder, tuloy-tuloy pa rin po yung ating home church video. Nagsisend pa rin po tayo ng link sa Tagalog. And yung link din po ng children home worship. So meron pa rin po yan. So pag panoorin po natin ang ating mga anak na nasa bahay lang, hindi pa po sila pwedeng sumama sa church worship. That's why kailangan na pa rin po nila na mag-worship sa kanilang mga bahay. I-guide po natin sa ayong ating mga anak, mga magulang. Okay po? So, yun lang po ang ating mga announcement. Maraming salamat po. Ngayon po, tayo po ay humanda na para sa ating pagbibigay sa Panginoon. Ito po yung confession ng ating pananampalataya sa ating Diyos. So, let us sing ang tanging anay ko.
Salamat po sa atin. kaming pinagsama-sama para po makapakinig ng salita po nyo. Salamat din po, Panginoon, na muli kaming nagkasama-sama dito, lalo na po ang si Pastora Mirna at ang aking mga segro. Panginoon, sa araw na ito, sana po ituloy-tuloy pa po ang aming pakikinig sa gospel at kung sibayan pa po namin ang aming pananalig sa inyo, lalong-lalo na po sa ngayon na dumarating na problema. Panginoon, alam ko po na hindi niyo po kami pababayaan sa anumang dumarating na ngayon na panibagong problema. Bigyan niyo pa po kami ng aming mga dapat namin pakinggan sa mga salita ng Diyos, lalo pa mga nandito kong ka-sister, ang mga music team namin at ang Pastora Mira namin. Maraming salamat po.
Amen. Marating niyo po tayong nakatayo at tayo po ay magpapasalamat sa Panginoon. Awitin natin ang Give Thanks.
Let us bow down our head and then pray to our God. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and great love our God Father and impression, influence, movements, and fellowship of the Holy Spirit to those who listen to the message, blessing of the desert. They decide to heal all our the unbelief and to heal all our the limitation through this the gospel. So that we will meet disciples and further the world evangelization to their family, household, to their business and travel, to our church and to the Philippines. Now, up to the end of the earth, may God be with you forever and ever. Amen.